letters. But yeah, so.
Well, I want a stage name.
You want a stage? I thought Savini is a stage name.
No. What could be a good stage name?
Savini.
No, I mean a stage name.
Maybe we should have a contest here.
Basil Bone.
Name Tom Savini.
Sex Machine.
Yeah, that's right.
What?
Sex Machine.
Like a dead man from a white oak tree, people sitting on porches thinking how things used to be. Dark night, it's a dark night.
Never live that one down, yeah.
He was the godfather of gore, that's all.
The godfather of gore, that's a good
one.
Well, it took a year of begging, but I finally got the dick gun, the crotch rocket. I do own that, but it took a year of begging, you know. And I never bring it to conventions, because airport security gives me hell when they see that in the bag.
You did, on 2000.
No, I did bring it. Yeah. The last time in...
Watch the video I gave you.
At where?
The DVD I gave you.
Okay, it's in Basel?
Yeah.
I brought it there, yes. Yeah, that's
Swiss
what...
Swiss let you bring
it. Yeah, I brought it to Switzerland. Airport security.
Neutral.
What is this? They wanted to know what that was.
The neutral country let you
But if you look at it, you can see that the bullets... Yeah. There's no way for the bullets to get into the cylinder. Yeah. You know?
It looks like
People come up to my table and they say, how did the bullets get into the cylinder? And I say, it's only a movie. They're not supposed to get in there, you know, so.
What the fuck?
Questions, yeah? Oh, you have questions, or? No question.
No, okay. Well, thank you.
Bye.
No.
You have a question you want to start? Maybe you start.
We would make up zombies, and there was a bar that stayed open till 2 a.m. And the zombies would go drinking and get drunk. A couple of them stole a golf cart and they drove into a pillar, cost $7,000 worth of damage, you know.
Wow.
But she says that the motorcycle gang
ruined the entire floor.
Caused damage.
So they had to pay for the entire floor. Richard had to pay for the entire floor of the mall, and then the glass door. That somebody blew up.
Gary Zeller.
Zeller blew up the glass door.
They fired him. It was a glass window. A floor to ceiling, a 25-foot glass window. When he set off the explosion, it shattered the glass. And the photographer was sitting on the floor, and the glass fell in, and not one drop of it touched her. It all fell around her.
Luckily.
So we thought, she's blessed. You know, she has a force field around her or something.
She was also the wife of the producer. That helped a lot, too.
That's probably why.
Yeah,
that's probably why. Richard did not let it happen.
Other questions?
Well, I got one.
Okay.
Dawn of the Dead was done almost 40 years ago, and Night of the Living Dead was done almost 50 years ago, and was a groundbreaking movie in the horror genre. So, when you did Dawn of the Dead, were you aware of the meaning of Night of the Living Dead for the genre, Tom?
Yes. I was doing a play, and I got a telegram from George Romero, and it says, we have another job, start thinking of ways to kill people. And it was Dawn of the Dead, and he said it's a sequel to Night of the Living Dead, which I was supposed to work on, but I enlisted in the Army and they called me in. So I was in Vietnam when George made Night of the Living Dead. So I always regretted that I didn't get to work on that, but I did get to work on Dawn. So it was a big thrill for me.
There's somebody out there. Come on, let's go. Start the car. Come on, start the car. Let's go. Come on, let's go. Start the car. Start the car. Get out of here.
Okay, so many people think, he's asking about my experience in Vietnam and how did it change me. It had a big effect on me. Some people think that my interest in special effects began in Vietnam, but it did not. It began when I was 11 years old, okay? Vietnam was a lesson in anatomy for me as a special effects guy, because I was a combat photographer. And I saw horrible stuff. I saw bodies, dead bodies, bodies blown apart, arms laying around, you know. But I was behind the camera. I mean, emotionally it was disturbing as hell. But behind the camera there was a safety, because I thought, how would I create that? You know, the blood color. A day later, the blood turns brown. So this was a good lesson for me, and I've done that in movies. My reputation for effects is that they are very realistic, because they have to be anatomically correct. You know, if I look at the fake stuff, And it doesn't make me feel the way I felt when I saw the real stuff. The fake stuff isn't real enough, you know what I mean? Yeah. So Vietnam had a huge effect on my special effects career as far as realism.
Say goodbye, creep.
So while I was supposed to be preparing for Dawn of the Dead, I was building Darth Vader on myself for Halloween. So, and I spent very little time creating the helicopter zombie or, you know, the other stuff. And I was Darth Vader that Halloween. And I was the only one. And I won the contest. You know.
Yeah, so that's how I first met Tom, because when he cast my head, he's got my head stuck in the rubber cement, and he couldn't get it out for like how long? An hour?
Rubber cement.
It was whatever it was.
Yesterday you said latex, today it's rubber cement.
Whatever it was.
It was plaster.
Stuck. But we
from now on, we know that it's plaster.
It was plaster.
I cemented her head
in
to the
plaster
table.
And left me there. and said, oh, this has never happened before.
That's right. Actually, it happened to my wife.
Yeah?
I did cement her head to the table. So we had to plow her head off the table.